have this in here too.
That way the tank does slip out.
Bring this down here, lock that over there. You're good there. Go ahead and grab it right here. And give a little lift to the tank. Make sure nothing slides out. Spin that around to this side.
Okay. Like this?
Good, yep. Just like that. And then we'll take this here. Make sure this is tight. Give us a little pull. Pull this over. Put this through here. And again, pull back and lock it.
Yeah.
And give it a lift right here to make sure that it's okay.
It's ready, Dave.
It's not slipping.
Nope.
So now you have weak pockets right here. Just a little buckle. So here, don't worry, I'll tighten that up.
Okay.
You
thanks.
Can undo this pocket here, pop that in the other side.
And those weight two,
you got 2 5s there. I gave you 2 4, so it's still down there, color coded. You guys, I gave you code 5. That should take a second. You need to add more weight as well. Regulator set.
Thank you.
And you'll notice on the regulator set, there's 2 regulators. One has a yellow hose, that's your OPCO, in case anything weird happens to your primary. So take your OPCO and your regulator hose, stand behind your tank, hold the regulator's going to your right, so hold the regulator to your right, undo this dust cap here.
I know this part.
You're good. So that'll go all the way out, that'll pop out, and then that O-ring should seal it. Snug it down, just finger tight. It doesn't have to be tight, very tight, just a little bit. The air pressure will lock. Next thing you want to do is that hose, it doesn't go nowhere. Are good with your flare hoses. So you can, yeah, go put that Velcro around there. Yes. Also, no, you'll see. Also, we just push down this button below in here. Give us a little push. Make sure it's okay there. Hold on. Alright, so everybody's hooked up now. Here. I've never seen it happen before, but there is glass in that gauge. I don't want it to fall on your face. So take your gauges, look at the one that has 1,000 on it, and hold that upside down on top of the tank. I have seen these O-rings go out, and I don't want that to hit the
like
eye.
This?
Yep. Oh. So hold, take this, hold this one here, just put it here so that way nothing pops in your eyes and turns it on. Turn it over. I don't want this to take a high pressure hit. And again, it's slowly turning. Turn it all the way over. Keep turning until it stops. Check your gauge, make sure you have about 3,000 PSI.
check.
Good. Alright, so there's a clip on those gauges. You can clip those. Little D ring right here for you. Clip this off first, and we'll get this together. And then check, take each one of your regulators, and you can just check it. Hurt the front. Make sure you're getting air. If it reflows, if it does this, if it doesn't stop, either put it in your mouth or put it in the water this way. Right, it does happen sometimes. They're dry right now, they're meant to be in the water. So if you push this, and it does this, put your mouth in the mouth. Your octo is one of the yellow hose, which is a little bit longer than the other hose. So your octo is through your body, it's a little bit longer. If your body needs it, he's going to go into this octo hole over here. You can pull on this and stick the mouth piece in. Put your finger and pull that and just jam it out. You have to pull really hard and then jam the mouth piece in. That'll come out quick. And at this point, if you haven't put weights in your pockets, you can go ahead and slide your weights into these pockets here. Put your weights there.
In these pockets.
No, put them in the fold down pockets. They're quick release. Alright, cool. Go ahead and check your primary right to make sure this one's working good. Alright, and there's a little adjustment on some regulators right here. If you have pre-dive or dive, it's a little baffling. It changes. But I have different regs, so you can try different things out next week if you want to try a different reg. But that way, when you jump in the water, it's on pre-dive, you're breathing a little bit harder. Alright, at this point, let's take our tanks a little bit closer to the pool, lay them down. And you guys can get ahead, start putting your wetsuits on, put your booties on, and put your fins in your mask right near your setup. Did you guys clean your mask out when you bought them?
Yep.
Clean them with toothpaste on your shirt?
Yep.
I got masks the frog with.
There is some defog if you need it. The chlorine breaks down the defog, so you might need to use a couple of that. Stick your mask in. Zipper goes in the back of your wetsuit.
Lou, is this just taking pictures or video?
Video. The button next to the orange cabinet. Got that?
Yeah. I've been filming you.
Remember, it's always important to deflate your PC before getting into the water.
Okay.
Giant stride. He's going to locate sure nobody's below him here. Then he's going to take a giant step.